Hi everyone, it's Jean Hansen, co-founder of the janitorialstore.com. So one of the things that a lot of cleaning business owners struggle with is when they need to expand and to grow their leadership, they look to hire some supervisors. And one of the things that I know I fell into this trap, and I know a lot of you do the same thing, is that you take a look at your employees and you look at your best cleaners, and those are the people that you promote into the supervisory position they have available. And then what happens is they don't do that great because they're great at cleaning, but they really aren't a great supervisor. And in most cases, it's because they've never had any kind of leadership training on how to become a good supervisor. And it's really hard to make that shift from being everyone's buddy to suddenly being their boss. So when I had our cleaning company, this goes back to the early 90s, we were struggling with this. And so I created a supervisor training program that we would go through with our supervisors and lead people at our weekly meetings. So we would just take the end of our meeting and just maybe 10 minutes, and we'd go over a topic that would help them become better supervisors. So I actually wrote this up into our own supervisor training program. It's been a training program that we've had available at the janitorial store for many years as a print program. Well, I wanted to make it more comprehensive and I wanted to bring it to video so it's a little more interactive. And so now we have a 7-part video series on janitorial supervisory training that you can get now at the janitorial store, and I'll tell you how to get that in just a minute. But I just wanted to give a little bit of an intro to what we do in the very beginning, and I'm going to do some other videos with some subjects that we cover in the supervisor training videos. But you know, one of the first things I have them do is I have several questions, and I want them to rate themselves true or false. So these are things that they might struggle with occasionally. So one of the things I ask some decision-making questions. So one of the questions is, I have a hard time making decisions under pressure. Okay, they have to be able to make good decisions under pressure. Another one is that I sometimes procrastinate. Procrastination is not a good thing in business, right? So we want to find out. And they tend to be more honest with themselves because I say in the beginning, this is not something that you have to turn into anyone. This is for your information. I want you to be really honest with yourself and answer these questions truthfully. I want everyone to like me. You know, that's a trap that a lot of people fall into because who doesn't want everyone to like them, right? But sometimes it's not going to happen. You have to be the supervisor. You have to discipline employees. Not everyone's going to like you for that, right? I don't have patience all the time for some people, right? So they have to be the calm, patient, constant factor in the team. And so those are just four of the questions. I have a whole series of questions that I ask them, but it's really revealing to them because if they answer a lot of these questions as yes, that I do tend to procrastinate, I do have trouble making decisions, then that tells them what they need to work on, right? And then the next section after that is instead of just going right into what makes a good supervisor, I talk about why supervisors fail. And I point out some of the very common things that causes supervisors to fail or not do a good job in certain areas, partly because it makes them not feel so alone, right? A lot of people think, well, I'm the only one that's struggling with this. And they don't want to talk to their manager about it because they don't want to seem like they're doing a bad job. They want, everything's great, right? So this really helps them understand that they're not alone, that a lot of supervisors fail, and a lot of people fail in certain areas. You know, cleaning isn't usually one of them. So that's just the first, you know, few minutes of the first video. So we've got a ton of stuff that we cover in this, and I'm going to quickly show you how to get the training. So if you go over to the janitorial store, there's two places you can get to our shopping cart. There's up in the top navigation, you can click on store, or you can go to shop now. And training videos, there's a little button here. You can also get to it from the navigation over on the left side. And it's right here, janitorial supervisor video series. So this is online access. When you place the order, you will get online access to all the videos. And this goes into detail about what's included. So there is a description of what's in every single video. So if you have any questions, be sure to let me know. Happy to answer any questions that you have. Check it out at thejanitorialstore.com. Thanks, and I'll see you with the next video tip on supervisor training.